Today I will create a registration form with validation using NodeJS and EJS. Firstly, I need to create a NodeJS project using npm init. Mention the project name. I leave rest of them blank. Then install config, express and EJS packages. Also installing NodeMon as dev dependency. Let's create some directory and files. Config directory will store app default configuration. View will store our EJS templates. And index.js is our application root. Mention the port in the default configuration. Here I use 8000 port. In our application root, import express and config package. Then get the port from the default configuration. Create an instance of the Express as an app. Set view engine as EJS and our static directory is views. To catch unwanted errors, set a middleware. Finally, mention an app listener to listen all requests from 8000 port. Inside the package.json, add the script to start the application. And add start dev to run the application with NodeMon. Here NodeMon will help to restart the application whenever we make changes in the files. Let's start the application. Here it's running in the port 8000. To create the EJS template, let's create assets, pages and CSS directory inside views directory. Here I will store the CSS inside style.css and registration page code inside registration.ejs. To reach the registration page, I need to route the root path to the render registration page. Now I'm starting the application using NodeMon. Let's structure the registration page with HTML. In the registration form, I need 4 input fields. Here our HTML structure is ready. Now decorate with CSS. Here I use form group border. And not require any border and background of the input fields. Lastly, I need to decorate the sign in text. Finally, our registration form is ready. To make it more attractive, I will use SVG icons for the input fields. For SVG icons, you will get hundreds of free SVG icons from webgraphics.com, link in the description. I am directly pasting SVG code inside HTML. It will keep our application light and fast to load. In case of lock keyhole path, it will be no fill. That's why I'm using class with fill none. Let's validate all the input fields. Here I will use JavaScript function. To check the valid email address, I'm using regular expression. I'm creating a function with two parameters, one for the input fields and another for the parent div. If the input field is empty, set the parent class invalid and remove the valid class. Then return false. Inside the else condition, check if the input field is email, then validate the email address. If all is good, then set the parent class as valid and remove the invalid class and return as true. This function will trigger when there is a change in the input field or stop typing. Now decorate the valid and invalid class. Here I need to change the color of the icons too. Now come to the password fields. Let's create another function as passvalid. First part will be similar to the fill valid function, but inside else I need to change. Let's check if both have same value or not. It can be done inside fill-valid function, but it will be little bit complicated. That's why I separated it. Here is the final result. In the second part, I will connect with MySQL database. If you're watching after just releasing this video, then wait for the second part or find the second part link in the description. If you find this helpful, please like and comment. Don't forget to subscribe.